Well, good afternoon from the lovely sanctuary of the Lighthouse Chapel. This is Pastor Hayton with another Lower Lights devotional. Christmas is just around the corner. Seems like there's a lot of activity. Everywhere you go, well, it seems like that there are lines waiting to be checked out with all the Christmas gifts and other holiday items that people are purchasing. I just kind of like to stay away from the stores this time of the year, but I can't avoid them all. But I can say I'll be glad when it's all over and the mad rush is all over and Christmas of 2017 is just history. But you know, I don't want it to be just history. I want to remember Christmas of 2017. I think that Christmas time ought to be a time of focusing on the Lord Jesus Christ. And of course we do that. We focus on him as he lays in a manger. Many dramas from churches and many live nativities. A lot of cantatas that are singing about Christ the child. And we do focus on Christ laying there in a manger in a Bethlehem stable. Know that this was God's gift to a lost world. It's a gift of grace. And I don't want to forget that Christmas is to remember God's great gift to us. And I'm thinking about, you know, God giving us his son, Jesus Christ, and how that is just a little bundle of grace. And when I think about that bundle of grace, I thought about how it's pulled me up out of sin. But King David said that he was in the deep miry clay, and he was going under. But the Lord lifted him out of the deep miry clay, set him upon a rock, put a new song in his mouth, a song of praise, hallelujah. And so this bundle of grace, he came not just to be oohed and awed over as a babe in a manger, but he came as a bundle of grace to pull us up. And then I think so often of how as we try to serve the Lord, we need help. I often say I need all the help that I can get. And boy, that's no understatement today. I have my battles every day of the world. I have things that I struggle with. I go through difficult times. I have those times when my faith is weak. I have those times when Satan plants doubt in my mind. And I don't think I'm the exception. I think that probably that's the way it is with most Christians, except those ultra-spiritual Christians that you find here and there. But I have to say that I need a bundle of grace that not only pulls me up out of sin, but it pulls me along. It's what gets me down the pathway of life. And how far could we make it in serving the Lord if it were not for the bundle of grace that God sent to pull us along life's way? Yes, his grace is sufficient, is what the songwriter said. And how often do we need an all-sufficient grace that will keep us going as we try to serve the Lord from day to day? I'm thankful for a grace today that lifts us up, grace that pulls us along, and there is a grace that can put us together. I believe that even as Christ prayed for his disciples, he prayed that they might be one. And I'm glad that God has enough grace through his son Jesus Christ to make us one. He can take us, and I think of our own church here, how we come from all different walks of life, different social levels, different economic status, different religious backgrounds. Well, we've got Lutherans, Catholics, we've got Church of Christ. I mean, there's just quite a conglomeration of church backgrounds in the congregation of the Lighthouse Chapel. But you know, this little gift of God's love, it's grace that brings us together, and it causes us to be the wonderful family of God in which we find much delight. So that little bundle of grace, Christmas is about God's grace, grace to lift us up, a grace to pull us along, and a grace to put us together as one. Heavenly Father, thank you for Jesus Christ, for the grace that he represents, for the grace that he offers. Help us to solely rely upon your grace in all the different circumstances of life. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, thanks for letting me share that, and I'll see you tomorrow. here on the Lord Lights Devotional with Pastor Hayton. Goodbye now.